All right, so here's today's project. This is my oxygen regulator for welding. And it's been in a box for a few years. I've been moving around a lot. Haven't had a chance to do much fabrication in the last few years. So finally was able to start hooking up my tanks to do a project, and the seat blew. So I ordered a rebuild kit. This has lenses in it, which I don't really need, but it has a new seat and a couple of important washers in there. So I'm gonna rebuild this today. So let's get started. I've already loosened everything, but I wanted to take it apart while you're watching. So that comes out. This unscrews, and then underneath it, you've got your rubber diaphragm. Well, first, this is what sits underneath the, I can't remember the names. Anyway, this is what helps regulate your pressure that's going out to your welding gun spring. And then this nylon washer type thing that allows you to tighten this down against the rubber diaphragm. The diaphragm's in good shape. It's a little dirty. I'm going to clean it. And then in here is the seat and those couple of washers I was mentioning. So let me take that out. Like I said, I sort of loosened everything so I could take a look at it before I ordered the parts I needed. So, first you'll see, be right back. I need a pick. Before I go much further, little background. I worked as a motorcycle mechanic for many years, mostly on Japanese bikes. Worked in a few shops that specialized on Harleys. I grew up with Japanese bikes, that's what I love. And the Royal Enfield, of course. I'm kind of self-taught, and what people taught me, and a lot of reading, long before YouTube was around. But now that YouTube exists and the internet, I use that a lot too as a resource. So I'm constantly learning new things. Like I mentioned earlier, I love rebuilding old bikes, restoring them, upgrading them. And now that I have a home again, I would like to do a whole lot more of that. Also, I've done a little fabrication, some welding, a little machining, mostly on a lathe. I haven't used the mill, but I know what they do. I've had people around me working with them, so I'm sure I can learn to use one. But I'm by no means an expert, a master, a certified anything. Well, I'm certifiable, maybe. But this is just stuff I like to do, and this is how I do it. There's probably a million other ways to do things. So I'm not saying my way is the best, it's just how I do it, you know, and I'm always trying to revise what I do, learn things better. Again, I've been out of this game for almost a decade, so I'm kind of getting back into it, and you're with me. Okay, enough about me. So, something to really understand here that I learned is they're not hard to rebuild, but you can have zero oil or any other sort of contaminants in here because that oxygen is at about 2,000 PSI, and just the force of that actually creates, I guess you'd call it friction, and it can ignite anything in here that's combustible. So you want to make sure your hands are clean. I don't have any nitrile gloves, otherwise I'd be wearing them, but I washed them very thoroughly. I've cleaned off my tools. Okay, so I'm picking out, here is that nylon washer. Can you see that? Opa. Dropped it. Here we go. Right there. So that's going to get replaced. Then here you have the seat sits in there. And then here you have the seat. Hopefully this is focusing. You can see this little orange kind of spitz in there. Spitz is a New York Yiddish term. I'm not I don't speak Yiddish, nor am I Jewish, but a lot of my friends and neighbors were, so Shputz or Shmutz, okay? Anyway, so this is what needs to be replaced. The spring will get reused. I'm replacing this little split washer back here too. Gosh, I hope you saw all that. Okay, sorry if you didn't. That sucks, but I'm gonna find out a better way to do this. Okay, so I have to kind of press this spring down to get that split washer out of there, because I will be replacing that. Oh, and you know, I should make sure this new seat is the same length. Now, I do have a model 2508 0540 that's printed right on the side here. It's in the brass. Now, my understanding is there are other model 2508 0540s that are not stamped in here. They take a different kit. Oh, and this kit was only about $16-$17 on good old eBay, as opposed to $200 for a new whole new regulator. And I do want to get a Cobra regulator, actually, because the Cobra torches work on very low pressure. And as you can see here, this output pressure, the lowest it reads at 10, and then it goes down to 8, 6, maybe 4. But you only use 4 or 5 pounds of pressure with the Cobra torch. So the Cobra regulators actually start at a much lower number, so you can more finely tune that low pressure you're going to be using. Okay, I'll get back to that seat. I want to just clean all this out, wipe it down with some Q-tips. I hope you can see that. I can't leave any cotton residue in there though, because that'll be bad as well. So I have to be very careful. It's dirty in here as far as, like, you know, age and use, but I don't see any oil, anything like that. I need to get some tweezers. Now, for you people that watch a lot of YouTube, you may get a feel for my video style here. There's a channel, Musty One. Oh, there goes Chewbacca. That's my phone. Musty One, I watch his channel a whole hell of a lot. He's really smart guy as far as fixing things, and just really, really good at it. He's been doing it his whole life. So he's kind of my inspiration. Actually, the camera I'm using, it's a Canon ELF, what is it? ELF 110HS is a camera that he has highly recommended. I love the quality of his videos and the audio. So I figured, you know, he's got the experience, I will follow that. And so I bought one. They don't make them anymore. They're obsolete. But I found one for a really good price. Once again, eBay. I'm a big eBay buyer. I just buy tons and tons of stuff on eBay. I'm popping this split washer out. Might as well replace it with the new one. This cup should only go on in one direction. You got your spring. I'm gonna wipe all this down. I don't want any oils on there. It could be very dangerous. I do wish I had gloves, but I think I'll be okay. So here's the, you can see the new seat versus the old seat. Can you see that? This one's a little thicker, but I'm gonna guess that that's a upgraded design feature. All right. Wipe that off. I'm gonna put this spring back on. And then you can see this has a side that protrudes here. And then it's dished on that side. The dished end has to go down because that split washer sits inside of it. And it should just pop right on, which it did. And then it has to sit inside of there, which I'm getting it to. Gotta be careful. It's not quite flush yet. I'd like to get it flush. And again, bear with me. I've never really filmed anything like this before, so it'll be kind of a learning experience for me. I just hope you like my projects, and you know, we'll spend time together. I might as well talk to somebody other than myself, right? Alright, so I'm gonna try again. Now it's all flat and in place. I'm sure that's kind of hard for you to see, but the split washer I just put in is kind of sticking up on one side. I'm gonna wipe it down a little. I have the new nylon washer in there. I'm gonna stick that in the center. Then I'm going to take, this nut has a hole in the center, the seat pokes through there, and that's when you press, turn down on this for the regulator to adjust the pressure, it presses down on this. So I'm just cleaning out some crap that's in there. I don't want to use my, compressor, because I don't have an air filter or an oil filter on it, and I would hate to blow this clean and have oil get introduced into this. So hence me not using it. But yeah, I'm sure blowing on it, spit is fine, right? So I'm gonna tighten that down. Just snug, it's all brass. Doesn't need to, I need to kill it. All right, so that's in. Next would be the diaphragm. Now, like I said, it's kind of dirty. You can see underneath there, I have a spray bottle here. This is just water and a, literally one drop of like dishwashing soap, which cuts grease, right? So I'm just gonna spray it. And I'm gonna take a clean paper towel. Paper towels, let's talk about that. COVID, remember? Like everyone went nuts and got toilet paper and paper towels. I don't know what the hell that was all about. Anyway, so I'm just wiping this down. I'm gonna wanna get all that water out of there for sure. But, just wanna get the dirt. There's like, my regulators must be, shit, 30 years old. But dude, they're totally rebuildable, you know? No sense in throwing something away, especially if it works. So, I see a little water in there. I'll set you back up here. I want to take that apart. Let's see if I can do this with you watching. Are you watching? Okay, look at that. Fancy. So I'm just gonna loosen this, being careful not to tear the diaphragm. This cap here has a spring inside. I'm gonna be really careful there. Don't wanna lose it. And because I've never done this, I like to take things out in order, put them back in order. So if you see here, we had this, the spring, this little nipple thingy. I said nipple, with a rubber O-ring on the back. Looks to be in decent shape, so I'm not going to mess with that too much. And popping that out. There's the diaphragm, and then this threaded really thin. And there's a hole in there, so must allow air and pressure to go through as necessary. Just gonna wipe everything off as best I can. Get rid of all the water. Again, being careful not to introduce anything oily or water or anything in there, really. Sounds like my neighbor's kids and friends are playing basketball. I hope that's not too noisy. All right, patting that dry. Spring. Okay, wiping everything off. Getting it clean. Again, no oil, no water, no nothing. Nothing. Another trick, I mean, for people that are of this generation, it's probably like a duh. But for people of my generation, I'm a Gen X. Yeah, baby. Gen X. We didn't really have cell phones back then. And taking a picture was a little bit of a, not the simplest thing, you know. So, now, anytime I disassemble something that I've never disassembled before, I use my camera, take pictures of it. Sound, again, for younger people, it's kind of a duh, you know. But for, I won't say older, but you know, whatever. Mature, wiser. Anyway, you know what I'm saying. It's a boon. It's great, especially, you know, when you're working on things. So this has witness marks on it. I don't know if you can pick that up in the camera, but I'm gonna try and sit this piece exactly on like it was on the witness marks. It's been there for 30 years. Why mess up a good thing, right? Okay. And that goes back on. Start screwing it down very carefully. Because again, it is all brass. I don't want to strip anything. Put it in my vise. Just tight enough. Hold it there. And I'll snug this down. Can't go crazy on it. But I do want it tight. Okay. Got one more. For anyone new to mechanics, a big part of it is feel. You really got to get a feel for things and how tight is tight. I remember when I was younger and I first learning, I would strip everything because I just thought you just tighten it as much as you can. I didn't realize there were different torques. I don't even know what torque was, you know? So my buddy Tom used to call me stripper, not only because of my lovely physique, but because I would strip everything I would get my hands on. All right, you'll have to excuse me. My battery died. So I promptly have ordered two new ones. Charged this one, but if things jumped around a little bit, that's why. My apologies. Okay, so back to the rebuild. I've taken the diaphragm. It was dirty, now it's nice and clean. Right, I'm getting all the crap off of it. What did we call that? Schmutz. The schmutz is gone. I'm just being real careful. Placing that in. And then the friction washer that goes on top of there. Now, got the top cap. Just want to wipe it out a little. There's nothing really in here. It's not dirty by any means. Pretty good shape. Not bad. There's something in there though. I can't quite tell if it's, at first I thought it was some kind of grease, but then you realize you shouldn't have any grease or oil in there. So then I just think it's just some sort of corrosion after all these years, but nothing a little Q-tip didn't just wipe right off. Getting rid of any excess hairs, cotton hairs. Do cottons have hairs? All right, now we've got our spring, swiping it off, just in case. And the little washer with the dimple, you can see it's dimpled. Wiping that clean. You gotta love Q-tips. They're doing work. All right. That goes on top of the spring. So, am I missing something? No. I think it's easier to turn this upside down. Pop these pieces in, right side up, out. It's a little sharp edge in there. Huh? See, good thing I checked. A little bit of fuzz or something in there. Then I put that and then on top. There we go. Perfect! Well, if you hear a lot of noise, it sounds like my neighbors and their kids are playing outside. Now, I'm gonna carefully screw that down. Oops, I guess I wasn't that careful. Now, was I? I want that diaphragm to sit in the right place. I guess I can get it to sort of pop in. When I removed it a few days ago, it was stuck in there. I was pretty sure I was gonna tear it. Thankfully, I didn't. And now it seems like I got it to sit right in where it belongs. Replace that friction washer. Replace that. Let's see if I can do this. There we go. That was pretty damn easy. Now, let me zoom out a little. And you'll have to excuse me now too. It's late here. I'm in New Mexico. Mountain time. And it's almost 10:30 p.m. I normally work nights, so this is still early for me, but My body's tired. Anyway, the easiest thing for me to now do is turn this upside down because I don't have a wrench big enough to grab that. So I'm going to grab that in the vise carefully. Doesn't have to be super tight, just enough to hold it from spinning. And I've got my 7/8 inch ratchet or socket on my ratchet that I cleaned. It's free of oils. And now I can snug that down. Again, not trying to kill it, but I do want it to seat so there's no leaking. All right. Now, that's together. Our final piece is the pressure regulating thingamabobber. That is the official name of it, don't you think? Don't you? I do. All right, zoom me back in here. Again, sorry if it's a weird videoing. I'm learning. Bear with me. We can grow together. And this is clean. I will reinstall it. But you don't want to put too much pressure on it because when you first turn the gas on, you don't want the pressure to build up on the outlet side. What I can do, I got these new covers. The old ones have paint spatter on them. I guess I can simply remove and replace. Is it that easy? Yeah, maybe not. Maybe they don't quite fit. All right, so much for that. They're still legible. It's not like you can't see what they say. They're just old, you know, had them for a while, used them. All right, that's that. I'm taking a look here. You always want to make sure that there's no damage to this area. That's where it screws into the tank. My outlet side. And that's that. It's rebuilt. Alright, let me put you on pause and bring you over to the tank. Alright, so this is the regulator we just rebuilt. Oxygen tank. This is your high pressure gauge. That's going to read how much pressure is in the tank. This is your low pressure gauge for your outlet going from through the regulator, hence the name, through the hose. And in this case, I have a cutting torch. Now, a couple of caveats here. I've never used this torch. This came with these tanks. I have oxygen here and an acetylene below that you can't see. They're old. They're maybe 15 years old, but the gas should be fine. The tanks are in decent shape. A little surface rust, but nothing crazy. But you should always be very careful about the quality and the shape of the tanks you're using. I'm zooming out so you can take a quick look. Look at my umbrella. Hey, actually that was here when I bought the house. See, I got two smaller sets of tanks here. This one and that one. I just got those from a friend. He gave them to me. I have good friends. And then you can see the larger, this is a huge acetylene tank here. And oxygen tank. So, like I said, never use this. These are old, haven't used them yet. But there's no reason they shouldn't work. One more thing, in case I fucked up, this thing can catch fire and explode. So if it does, this will never get uploaded and my house will go goodbye. I don't think that's gonna happen, but wish me luck. All right, let me zoom in a little so you can see what's gonna happen. Right there,
And I'll zoom in. You can see the gauges. Can you see them? Let me reposition you a little. There we go. Going a little closer. How's that? You want more? All right. Since you asked nicely.
All right, so what should happen, this is backed out, so there should be no gas coming out of the outlet. That's the problem I was having the other day. The seat wore and it was letting gas out all the time. So when I open this slowly, ever so slowly, this should go up to about 2000 PSI. And then when I push that in, it'll give me some outlet. Let's try. Wish me luck. Please don't die. Okay, that's a good sign. I'm gonna keep turning. So you see how this went up? It's actually at about, let's see, 1700 PSI. The tank could be getting empty. It could be the temperature as well. I don't hear any hissing. So now I'm gonna slowly turn this in, and that should raise the pressure that's gonna be allowed to come out of the outlet. Wish me luck again. There it goes. Can you see it slowly going up? And as I turn this, that goes up. So that's good. Let's see if it holds pressure. I'm gonna put it on a high speed frame. Okay, let's see, it's 2 hours later. It's actually 5 seconds later. But yeah, it's holding, that's good. That's a great sign. The best part is the rebuild of the regulator worked. So rather than having to spend a couple $100 on a new regulator, I spent $17 and rebuilt it. Okay, I hope that was enjoyable. I liked it. I'd like to do a lot more. Like I said, I'll work out camera angles better and projects and things. Hopefully you find it interesting. Again, my name's Constantine. My friends call me Con. And we'll talk again soon. Okay, see ya.